distance of a point from a line. So then you can see in the picture, AB is the line and CD is a segment which is perpendicular to line AB. The segment CD intersects line AB at a point D. So CD is the perpendicular distance. CD is the perpendicular distance on line AB. Now of segment CD, D is called as the foot of the perpendicular. D is called as the foot of the perpendicular. Now children, when we measure length CD, that length gives me the distance of point C from the line AB. When we measure the length of the segment CD, that length gives me the distance of point C from the line AB. Now, suppose if I take length CD as 2 cm, if I take this distance as 2 cm, this shows that the point C is 2 cm, is at a distance of 2 cm from line AB. So I repeat, if segment CD is perpendicular to line AB and the point D lies on line AB, then the length of segment CD is called the distance of point C from line AB. The point D is called the foot of the perpendicular. If length CD is 2 cm, then C is at a distance of 2 cm from the line AB. Now children, let me just give you homework 6 for the day. Now to take homework 6, we have to go to problem set. In problem set, we have got question 3. Here see children, what is given? Coordinates of some pairs of points are given below. Okay. Hence find the distance between each pair. Now when you look at sums 1 to 7, all the sums look similar except the 4th and the 5th one. Now look here children, how to do the 4th and the 5th one. Now in the 4th sum, the coordinates are given as x and the other coordinate is given as x minus 2. Now to decide x and x minus 2, let me consider x as 5. Now if x is equal to 5, here x I get as 5. Whereas here for x minus 2, I will write it as 5 minus 2, which gives me 3. So where you are getting a greater answer? You are getting greater answer here as 5, and 5 is greater than 3. This shows that x is greater than x minus 2. So how do we proceed? We will write here, since x is greater than x minus 2, distance between the points, will be the greater coordinate, that is the greater coordinate x minus the smaller coordinate x minus 2. So when you open the bracket, we get it as x minus x. This minus into minus gives me plus. So plus x and minus x gets cancelled. So I get answer as 2, and 2 is positive. So the answer is correct. Always distances need to be positive. Now in a similar way, let us also do the next sum, which is the 5th sum. For the 5th sum also, the coordinates are given to us as x plus 3 and x minus 3. Now let us decide first which is greater. For x plus 3 and x minus 3, again let me take x as 5. If I take x as 5, I get 5 plus 3, which is 8. And again if I take x as 5, I get 5 minus 3, which is equal to 2. And as you know, 8 is greater than 2. So that implies that x plus 3, this coordinate is greater than the other coordinate x minus 3. So we will write here, since x plus 3 is greater than x minus 3, distance between the points, distance between the points is going to be the greater coordinate x plus 3 minus the smaller coordinate x minus 3. Now let us open the bracket, x plus 3 minus x, and this minus into minus becomes plus. So plus 3, so minus x and plus x gets cancelled. 3 plus 3 is 6. 3 plus 3 is 6. Now look here, children. Problem set 1, question 3. Out of 7 sums, the 4th and the 5th sum is done for you. The 4th and the 5th sum is done for you. The remaining, that is 1, 2, that is the 1st sum, 2nd sum, 3rd, 6th and 7th. These 5 sums are homework for you, whose solution will be given in the next video. Now, come back to practice set 1. Here children, the last question, question 7. Which figure is formed by 3 non-collinear points? Now you can see I have drawn 3 non-collinear points here. If I take these two, they are along the same line, but this is taken away. When I take these two points, these two are giving rise to a line and this is on one side. And when I consider these two points, this point on top is taken on the other side. Now what if I join these 3 points? What if I join these 3 points? I get 3 line segments and this closed figure that I have got is called as a triangle. And the closed figure so obtained by making use of 3 non-collinear points, the figure that is obtained is called as a triangle. It is a closed figure bounded by 3 line segments and hence what we get is a triangle. What we get is a triangle.